Welcome to another episode of the Listen to Your Network series presented by VRV Solutions. My name is Christoph Gehlen and I'm a sales engineer. Today's topic is VPN Gateway Report, a VPN versus in-house. Let's get started. In the past, working from home was an option, but now it is a necessity for many of us. This rapid change challenges every IT organization and introduces a risk to the IT operation. Ensuring that employees can work well in-house as well as working from home is a tough task to ask, especially as the remote environment is not under your control. Hence, it is essential to be able to understand the user's performance, regardless if they are where they are located. As this exercise is important right now, it will still be useful during operations under normal conditions. Let's just have a look at a few issues that could impact the performance of VPN users. PCs or laptops used at home? Is it a company-provided PC or not? What about malware and viruses? Do we need to think about security risks we might introduce now? Local connections of the user to a wireless LAN. The ISP bandwidth and latency, what about that? The VPN access and the latency added. Highly utilized VPN gateways can also cause issues and many more. And in addition to all of these issues, the VPN users would still experience issues that the in-house users would see as well, such as highly loaded servers, misconfigured network connections, slow applications, and more. Taking the problems aside for a moment and looking at the simplified network topology here, showing the users behind the VPN connector and showing also the in-house users that work from your premises. On the right side here, I add the observer solution comprising of NTAP, GigaStore, and Apex. While the Observer GigaStore is capturing all the packets traversing the network, it does evaluate the performance of each conversation. The performance figures are continuously calculated and delivered to you by an easy-to-use front-end Observer Apex. With this, you are now able to monitor the user's experience when they use your applications through the network, regardless if they're in-house or if they're connecting via VPN. Let's have a quick look into this EUE score that is the essential KPI used in this exercise. The EUE score is a patent-pending calculation that provides you with an easy-to-understand number from 0 to 10. It is derived from 30 underlying KPIs. Some of you might know, such as delay measurements, retransmissions, TCP window sizes, and many more. Besides the score, there is another further step done. The domain that contributes most to the degraded performance is pointed out. Those domains are application, client, network, or server. While each conversation will be evaluated automatically for you, the Apex structure will present the conversation performance in a structured multidimensional view. Furthermore, Apex will guide you with workflows to the most granular details for an effective troubleshooting when required. At all times, you can isolate the problem domain with a single click on the EUE score. The ultimate goal is not only to report the performance, but also to help raising that score, as you can see here, from 6.5 to 10. With the help of the UE score, the workflows and the ability to provide access to high-level forensic data in the time to resolve issues is drastically reduced. But now let's have a look at the APEX front end and see how it can help to compare the UE scores. For the comparison of different locations, also known as sites, the APEX front end facilitates this view. It is a built-in view that is available right out of the box. It delivers everything we need for this use case already. Here's an overview about the currently configured offices. You can see here Ratingen, Inning, and Hamburg, and some more. We also see the EOE score pointed out here besides each of those sites over time, actually, and here the added up value. Actually, we're almost there. We see now the office locations, and we just need to add the VPN users, right? So just let's do it. Defining a site for VPN users is easy. The information you need is shown here. First, you would need a name for the VPN site. In this example, I've just chosen VPN. And then you'll need to define a location. Well, a location for VPN users does not usually make too much sense, so I have chosen a location where I know that there is no physical office location. In this case, I've chosen an island, actually. And then you'll need the subnet name and, of course, the IP range of that subnet. Afterwards, you click Submit. By the way, you can use the CIDR notation to make it easy. And then this is applied in your dashboard. So that's now ready. Let's apply it and have a look at the result. So now you can see the recently added site in the map here, up there in the Northern Sea, and you can also see it down here. I've chosen this location as it is not conflicting with other sites in the map, and it's obvious for me and to my colleagues that this is not a real office location. In the table below, you see now the site is added, and we can see the EUE score now for the VPN users. And watch this, it is 9.9. That's pretty high, and it gives me the comfortable evidence that I do not have to worry about the VPN users for now. Actually, I better watch what's going on in Ratingen, or maybe here with the voice over IP quality. Let's summarize what we did today. With just minimal effort, we achieved our goal to monitor the performance of all our users, and we compare now the VPN users versus the in-house users. It can be that simple. This concludes today's presentation. Thanks for watching. Please join us for the next topic in this series coming soon. For more information, please contact me, Christoph Gehlen, directly using the email you see here, or go to our website at viavisolutions.com/ptv.